are on the bus from Dundee to Aelith, and it was a pretty cheap bus, so I was pretty excited about that.
Yes.
So we should be there in about 40 minutes, and then we'll get picked up by Oliver at the
station.
And
then we're going to Glenisla.
So dramatic.
I know.
This is Oliver. He picked us up from the bus station and drove us into Glenisla. He and his wife, Eileen, own the bed and breakfast where we stayed in Glenisla. It's called West Frookies.
Glenisla, it's this tiny little town, and it's kind of out here in the middle of nowhere, and we're just like surrounded by beautiful trees and nature and broom bushes that I like, and yeah.
So tiny that the only buildings that are in the town are the hotel, which is the pub, and the church, and the school, which is probably going to close.
Because it's too small.
So,
yeah,
it's a small town.
We're in this absolutely gorgeous glen in Glenisla, the Glen of Isla, and it's really cool to be here because this is where my ancestors came from. My great-great-great grandfather was born here in this glen, in this valley. And I wish that, Grandpa, you'll be watching this, I wish that you could come here and I wish that you could be here because it's absolutely gorgeous and I know that you would love it. And it feels very at home, and I can imagine how the five brothers who came from Scotland, the Robertson brothers who came and settled in Spanish Fork, Utah, how they might have felt at home in Spanish Fork, because the country kind of resembles the country here. And so it's absolutely beautiful. It's thrilling to be here.
We're in this little pub in Glenisla that is part of Glenisla Hotel, and we're eating dinner in here.
Eileen and Oliver were telling us that the Glenisla Hotel used to be a coach inn, so people coming by in coach would stop here and have a drink and spend the night, and it was probably here in like the 1840s, early 1800s, when the Robertsons would have been in this area, and so very well could be that some of my great 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 grandparents ate in this pub when it was the coach inn, because they weren't Mormon back then. They probably drank too, because that's what people do in Scotland. So right behind me you can see this old fortress called Meikle Forter, and in the Blue Robertson history book that I have, there's some pictures of it when it was in ruins, and since then they've renovated it. But it says in that book that William Robertson and Helena Mackenzie, who was his wife, could have been born, if not in this fortress, then like somewhere in this area up here is where they would have been born. But yeah, so that's Meikle Forter, and this is the Glenisla.
Alright, we're sitting on the bank of Loch and Table Loch right now, and we're having tea.
Eileen sent with us a thermos of hot water so that we could have tea on our hike. This is the tallest mountain in this area. It's overlooking the glen of Glenisla, and it's called Mount Blair. The yellow flowers that are all around are called Scotch Broom. That's the name of the flowers that we like that are so vividly yellow. So we were walking along and we saw this dome thing up here. We were curious as to what it was, so now we're going up to see. And this guy was walking by with his dog, and we asked him, and he said we could come up and look. So that's what we're doing.
and sacred to the memory of the following name who fell in the Great War of 1914-1919.
So that means World War One?
This is a World War One memorial out here in the middle of Glenisla, which is really cool. There's a Robertson.
Captain John Robertson. I wonder if we're related. Oh, that one's like scratching its nose.
Right now we're at the church in Glenisla, in the graveyard, and hopefully we can find the gravestone of William Robertson. Hopefully it might be here. So that's what we're looking for, and to see if there's any other Robertson names here in the graveyard.
Robertson.
December.
There's a Robertson.
We actually found many Robertson names as we searched among the headstones, most of them dating from the mid-1800s to the early 1900s. Finally, we came upon the headstone that we had been looking for. This is the grave of William Robertson, who was my five greats, great-great-great-great-great-grandfather. He was the father of, John Robertson, who was the father of another John Robertson, who was the person who came to Spanish Fork. So this is my direct ancestor, William Robertson. And it says, to the memory of William Robertson, who died on 27th of October, 1823, age 65 years, and his daughter Margaret. Cool discovery, that was kind of exciting to find here. So my ancestors left Glenisla on January 1st, 1850, and it was Elizabeth Edwards, who is the daughter-in-law of William Robertson, whose grave we found. She was the wife of John Robertson, who is his son. But Elizabeth Edwards Robertson crossed the ocean with her sons. And so they left here in 1850, so that's 158 years ago. And now I've come back 158 years later to this place where so many of my ancestors were born. So it's a really cool, cool experience. That I get this chance to come back here kind of to my roots and where I'm from, and this is part of my heritage, and there's just this feeling of peace and kind of like this elation at being here. I can feel a connection with my ancestors who have gone before me, and their spirits are still here, you know, and I know that there's that connection and that we're all sealed together and that I'll see them again one day. And so this is really cool to be here.